How did you meet Dave and Craig? How did you come to meet
them? Well, it was by fate. There was an all-star jam for the Keystone Palo Alto. A celebration of Keystone Palo Alto is happening at a now closed club here in the San Jose area. And Dave happened to be in attendance. So I was up singing with the band that Craig was in at the time, Max 12, and we were up there doing Smoking in the Boys Room.
Yep.
And Dave was out in the audience, and he came up to me after the show, and he goes, hey, doing some songs. Want to see if you want to hear them? Because I'm doing a recording project. And I was in a band at the time that was falling apart, and I wanted to get into a project that was going to record an album. And the rest is history. Huh. Here we are. I heard Dave and Craig's songs, and I'm like, oh, where do I sign up?
Yeah, it's kind of like somebody just driving you to there, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, no, I understand.
Yeah. No, it was all a beautiful accident.
That brings us to Dave.
That's right.
Oh, Dave.
Tell us about your inspiration, Dave, and what got
back,
you.
Let's get some musical accompaniment.
I was about 10 years old, and I started playing drums. I was in drums in all the bands in high school and stuff. And at 15 years old, I found that it was hard to practice drums. So I went and bought a new drum set. The parents were like, you can't practice. So I switched to guitar at that point at 15, I think. I saw the Zeppelin movie called Song Remains the Same.
Oh,
I thought
right.
That was the coolest thing in the world.
It was.
And I became a Kiss fan. I started learning like Detroit Rock City and started learning some Kiss songs. And then after that, you know, I was a pretty fast learner. So I think I was like 16, 17 in bands already, and at 18 I was already playing in the clubs full time for my job. So I was already doing like 60 songs a night in Alaska playing. So I've always written songs in all the bands I've been in. I've been the main songwriter, and I love writing songs. I'm pretty much I write as many songs as these guys. I got like, you know, 10 on hold that, you know, I'm trying to get them to learn. So basically, at the beginning of this band, I was playing a cover band for about 5 years, and I was kind of a little unhappy with my guitar playing and my motivation. So I said, you know, I want to get a recording project going. I wrote about 4 songs on a demo that I thought were pretty cool. And then I said, Craig, man, I want to record these. I want a real drummer like Craig to play on, not just my, you know, mechanical drummer.
Right.
So then I said, well, and then I was like, well, I was thinking, I don't know if I was smoking something, but I thought, you know, maybe I could try singing it. And I'm like, Craig's all, dude, no. Do not do that. That would be the biggest mistake ever. So,
what a pal.
So yeah, so Craig was pretty honest about that. So then I saw Tim, and I wanted a good, great front person that could not only sing really well, but also entertain the crowd. So, you know, you can't stop watching the guy. No idea what kind of a pain in the ass he'd be, but
what lead singer isn't? I'm just doing my job.
LSD, everybody's got
it. Not that bad. But so then I said, hey Tim, you know, I knew Tim 20 years ago. He was best friends with my keyboard player in my other band. So I called Tim. I said, dude, we got to check this out, man. What do you think about these songs? He's like, oh, these are cool. So it was like 2 weeks later, and I talked to Craig, and Craig got me a gig where we got into the studio, and we used his son, and his son was amazingly great. He played like all these songs. He had one practice for 2 hours and learned 4 songs like perfectly. So we went in there, and we nailed those songs. It just sounded great, and we got Tim. Tim was like, holy shit, 2 weeks later, we're getting here calling you to go and do a studio session. So that's where it started, and I'm pretty happy with the fact that we're doing some pretty cool melodic songs. People, you know, dig in this era. Not a lot of, you know, like bands like Journey that, you know, just wrote the greatest songs in the world. I kind of have an inspiration to be a band that's, you know, writing as good songs as that.
Right.
But I think we've got a great chemistry in this band.
I think you do too.
Great drummer, man. We got an awesome lead singer who's just the greatest front person. And we have multi-talented Alana here, who's just picked up the whole thing. And I make her do a lot of hard shit. I mean, she's like playing keyboards, playing guitar, and then singing really
dancing
high.
Her head.
On top of that. And then Wynn is pounding the bass. And dedicated. I mean, Craig and I and Wynn, we practice. Like, I don't know about yourself, because I don't know what you do. But we practice like crazy. I mean, I seriously practice 2 hours a night myself, and in that comes the songwriting.
Right.
And then, you know, Craig has been inspired to be, you know, the next Louis. What's that guy's name? Louis something?
Louis Belson?
Yeah, Louis Belson. You know, double major. And then Wynn is just like, you know, I challenge her quite a bit. I say, try this, boo, dude. And she's like, holy shit. So it's been a great thing. I think we got a great chemistry, and I personally think, you know, you can't really make it in the industry without just loving what you're doing. It's not about where we can make it. I know how to do it. It's about loving what you're doing, and that comes off stage, and the chemistry we have. that's what makes this band great.
No, when you guys perform, that shines through. I remember Tim was complaining about that show at Netto's. Oh, we screwed up. I was like, nobody else knew but you guys, okay? Because you guys were just loving it.
We didn't know either.
Yeah, we didn't know. We had no idea.
But listen, that was, you had hardly any audience at that show, but you guys, you brought it through and you performed like there was 1,000 people there, you know? And that's what you got to do, you know? And you guys are doing what you got to do, and you're having a great time doing it. That shows too.
Yeah, that's our goal. And to be, you know, to actually have a great show and some really good songs is a cool key to what this band's trying to do. So
we're working on flames, though. We want to have some explosions and, you know, flames on stage.
Pyrotechnics.
They have to be blue flames, though.
No!
So we have to probably get PG&E to get natural gas fly up, right? So it stays a blue flame.
Yeah.
That would be cool.
Just all of a sudden.
Flaming.
So is there anything you want to tell us about something up future? Why don't you tell us a couple gigs coming up so that we can put that on the...
Well, Tim...
It's the Taste of Morgan Hill Festival. It's happening on the 29th, Sunday the 29th. We're going to be there from 1 until 3 o'clock performing on the 2nd Street stage. Then we return to Morgan Hill to be honored that we're part of the first Kinsert that's happening in Morgan Hill, and that's happening on October the 12th, which is a Saturday. We'll be on there from 5 until 5:25, so they're giving us a 25-minute set. Then we come back to Netto's to really give it to them this time the real way, and hopefully to a huge audience because we're supporting Diamond Lane, and that's happening on Friday, November the 1st.
Okay, also, besides that cool stuff, we're recording 2 more songs coming on the October 5th. We have the song you just heard about, the cancer fighting song, You Won't Take Me Down. It's going to be like a kind of a bonus track we're going to, you know, record and have great. And then the other song you missed at the beginning was Raise Up Your Flag, which is actually going to be the title song for the next CD. Those are starting to be in the studio for us. And we're constantly moving forward, this band. We're learning new songs. We're just constantly just going. That's my opinion, of course.
No, it's true.
Yeah.
It's true. That's the idea.
I like pushing the
everybody. We're already talking about the second album, and Plug Me In's only been out for 6 months. 6 months on the 22nd of this month. So we're already talking about the next album. We've already got the title track and the title of the album. So with this guy, we're hanging on like this. He's like this.
He's the tiger, and you're holding the tail.
We're just holding like this. But it's a great ride. So here we go. On to 2014. We're ready.
Great. That sounds like a good way to end the interview then. All right. That was great. That was a great little interview there. And I'm sure that when we do the interview at the gig, we'll have some more in-depth questions.
Yeah, it'll be fine.
Good. Okay.
Hello, RC Radio!
SanJose.RCityRadio.com.